See, what happens is many schools of homeopathy, they have got, even some doctors have got something called as, I will call a prejudice, that when the patient comes, give only importance to mind. Answer is no, you should give equal importance to both mind and body, because mind and body cannot exist separately. Though we will be focusing today only on the mind rubrics, but idea is not that we should be only on mind rubrics. Idea today, our idea is to understand the mind rubrics. Different repertories have given different rubrics, sometimes pertaining to the same circumstances or same situation or same statement what the patient may be telling. So we should at least once read all the rubrics in the mind chapter of different repertories. Secondly, we should also try to understand that none of the repertory is complete. Like, for example, there are some very good rubrics which are found in a particular repertory which are not in present in the other repertory. When we talk about examples, we will talk about that. So let us start with the rubrics, mind rubrics. Now first let us go to some situations where the patient says something and how it can be interpreted into mind rubric. Let us start with that. All the examples what I am going to show you today to you are basically from my own practice. And this is a part of the book which was not released in the market, but it has been released for the training purpose of doctors who are working in my clinics. Now let us take this statement as an example. Patient comes and tells you, "Doctor, no one in my family takes proper care of me as I am born out of unwanted pregnancy." Now patient has come, he is the fourth child in the family. In the process of growing up, later on he learns that his parents did not want this pregnancy, and since the circumstances were that they could not terminate the pregnancy, he was born or she was born. Now this particular fact, when he came to know, had a major impact on the mind of the patient, and he has come and given you this statement. What do you mean by it? How will you put this in mind rubrics? Forsaken feeling, very good. Neglected. What else?
Delusion.
What kind of delusion? It could be a delusion also, yes. Delusion, neglected, yes. Yes.
Delusion being a stranger.
What else?
Complex.
What kind of complex? Now we are converting into repertorial language. Repertorial language mein kya rahega? Delusion, not cared, something. Abandoned. Delusion, alone in the world. Delusion, neglected. He is despised by his family. Delusion, deserted, forsaken, and estranged from family, her, etc. So you see, one statement will give rise to so many different rubrics which can be interpreted from the statement of the patient. So today, right now, our idea is to interpret the statement and what possible rubrics it can be. There can be some other rubrics also. Okay. Now we go to the second statement. Doctor, nobody in family appreciates whatever I do for the family. I do everything possible for my family, but nobody cares for me. Now last time we had a statement given by one of the patient where he said he is born out of unwanted pregnancy, Now you find this is a statement, nobody cares for me in the family, appreciates whatever I do for my family. I do everything possible for all the members of the family and still nobody cares. See what happens when the patient is giving often some information. This often information is basically coming from the innermost feeling of the patient. Now these kind of statements will generally come up when you say, ask the patient, and patient is slightly comfortable with you. If you remember last time, those who were present last time, I had touched case taking briefly, where I had explained when the patient takes a pause while narrating his complaints, that means something very deep is going to come out. So when the patient has taken a pause and we are talking something about the major stress factors what he is facing in the life, our patients are pushed there. आपकी लाइफ में स्ट्रेस फैक्टर्स क्या क्या हैं या मेजर स्ट्रेस आपने लाइफ में क्या क्या फेस किए हैं या समटाइम्स यू आस्क और बताइए आपका आपके फैमिली मेंबर्स में या ऑफिस में रिलेशंस कैसे हैं या क्या चल रहा है तो यू विल फाइंड पेशेंट टेक्स अ डीप ब्रेथ डज नॉट से एनीथिंग फॉर फर्स्ट फ्यू सेकेंड्स दैट मीन्स समथिंग मेजर इज देयर विच इज ट्रबलिंग हिम नाउ वैसी सिचुएशन में दिस स्टेटमेंट हैज कम अप फ्रॉम अ लेडी What can be the possible rubric? Delusion not appreciated. Appreciation want of. Sacrifices for the family. Dejected feeling. Neglected. What else if the statement is not correct? If the patient is telling you a lie? Suppose, let us see, she is not telling a lie, she is talking to her situation of mind. It is the innermost feeling which is coming to the forefront. Nobody appreciates me. See, all the things what we have talked in the previous statement can be there, and there can be sympathy, compassion, desire for. Along with that, flattery, desire for. Praise. Because here there are two elements. One element, nobody cares for me, and second, nobody appreciates me. So you see, the rubric has changed with the statement. So these kind of statements which come often will give you a very clear-cut idea of what the patient is feeling, what is the innermost situation, and that will give you the correct rubric. Now, a simple statement coming, nobody cares for me. Yes, neglected feeling, forsaken feeling. Now, this is a simple, alone, yes, it can be. Abandoned, delusion, alone in the world, delusion, neglected, delusion, forsaken. Now this is only one statement which the patient gives. Now this statement compared with the first statement, I am born out of unwanted pregnancy. If we compare this statement and that statement, is there any difference? I have not written one rubric in that which can be added now, which I want you to think and apply and add. Doctor, nobody cares for me as I am born out of unwanted pregnancy. Now, this statement up to here is okay. Isme hum first statement add karte hain if the patient says, as I am born out of unwanted pregnancy. Then, I will give you the rubric. You tell me what you have to ask the patient to confirm it. Unfortunate feeling. If there's an unfortunate feeling, then what will you ask the patient to confirm it? Like, you can't ask directly like about your fortune in this thing.